Hello everyone, welcome back to Total War Warhammer! If you were looking for a massive update from yesterday's episode, well, too bad. You can go watch yesterday's episode. Link at the end of the video. In the meantime, we have hemmed in this son of a bitch. He's got nowhere really to go. So, after reviewing our horses, including... We need to do a lot more moving, though. I am personally not interested in the Slayer Crown anymore. I need to march. Actually, you know what? Where's the Slayer Crown? Where's the Axe of Dargo? Okay, I need to march and go fight because I want the Axe of Dargo. See, you really don't have enough turns, and the game progresses a little too quickly to really complete these storyline missions. Mio is definitely heading back to reinforce and rearm. We are only temporarily occupying Kislev till we can march. Tripod's course is set. Garrick is in position. Jesse is protecting Kislev as well, till the two of them can march north and challenge what is left up here. Durgis! Durgis's army is complete. Durgis is going to get a move on. I would engage, however. See the problem. And we are technically the only thing standing between Hergid and certain destruction, since we have failed Wolfenburg! Damn. Can't believe we failed Wolfenburg like that. We'll have to make up for this error in our judgment. I thought Wolfenburg could hold out for more than a single turn. I was wrong. They have, of course, coming through to fuck with us. As he suddenly realizes, oh shit, I don't have a lot of places I can go. So he starts marching towards Brass Keep. Thing is, though, that's a dead end. And we'll leave that, the final army of the Chaos marching upon us. Nowhere to run nor hide. At least I believe he's the final army. We've defeated the Ever-Chosen. Sigvald has been defeated. Oh, you bastard. Carrion's assassination belonging to the Warriors of Chaos. That's no good.
Let us begin.
Your assault on my army successfully did, like, no real damage.
Onward. Ever.
Do I have a character here that can do assassination? Can you? You go, Trek and Felix, do not do assassination. Ooh, Dwarven Keep. The dwarviness is on. Population surplus, you say? Ah, it's not enough. Damn. However, upgrades can be performed elsewhere, which is kind of nice. I gotta say. Crooked Fang Fort can receive its upgrades as well. Good. This is good news. I would say you need beer, because we're dwarves. We don't have enough beer. Like, we really don't. We should have more beer everywhere. Everywhere should have more beer. We're dwarves, after all. Zufbar proper has been upgraded. Alright, that's coming out of global. Everything's gonna have to come out of global. I need you to get two squads of Slayers in order to complete your very, very basic army here, Shadow, and have you start marching. In the meantime, our first battle Tango leading... Actually, you know what? Alabaster, with all of his advanced craziness, will lead the assault.
Ready. Moving, my axe.
Tango and Hetty will move to support.
Time to slay the Oathbreakers. Shoulder axes, lads.
Drive them in. Let's fight this one! We've got flamethrowers and organ guns! And Gotrek and Felix have arrived! This will be a battle! I feel it in my bones!
Gorby's chariots are a problem. The warhounds are completely not a problem. Because warhounds are useless against dwarves, really. And considering his army composition... I... am voting to make them march up the damn hill after us. Five Malay squads. Gotrek and Felix. Alabaster. Our cannonade. Cannonade, everyone. With organ guns in the center. Now we're gonna move these guys down a little bit. So that we can make room for our thunderers. And our quarrelers. And out front here, we're going to place our Iron Drakes with their flamethrowers. Because of their incredible short range. Start the battle. As anticipated, chaos marches towards us, and we'll have a hell of a time getting here.
We're gonna speed this up a little bit, everyone, because you know what? I don't feel like waiting for them. I may be playing dwarves, but I don't have the patience for it.
And they're almost in range of our cannons. Excellent. On this fine, merry day.
Oof! He dead! Oh, they just eating cannonballs now.
Kill in the name of the gods!
These armored trolls? No, they're regular trolls.
Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo! How you guys like them cannonballs?
I'm getting the distinct impression you don't particularly care for our cannonade. Oh, and the organ guns! Oh, God! The organ guns have opened up! An extra height and on the hill firing into a valley gives them a super long range with the organ guns. I want that troll unit slaughtered. We have incoming. On the flank. I want you lot to form up double time. And I want you lot to bring yourselves to bear there. In the meantime, continue firing at their center with everything we have. Those trolls need to die from cannonade. Hold on a wee moment. Appears as though they are attempting to outflank us on the other side as well. Order of repositioning. Gotrek and Felix attempted to charge you straight into that. Let's do it. You straight into there, and I will engage the horsemen.
We've shattered a unit. And the Chaos Trolls are broken as well. Artillery. Open fire on those trolls. We're about to break their center. Their center rakes. Flamethrowers! Iron drakes! Let them have it. Alright, break off your charge here and charge into that. Focus down those Gorbeast chariots. Ooh! Fire! How you like them apples? Why have you dismounted your guns? That doesn't make any sense. Pull back. Remount the guns. Pull out your weapons and fight. Turn and fire. Iron Drake's taking heavy casualties. I need you to target them. Ooh-hoo! How do you like flamethrowers, bitches? Burn to cinder! Oh, those organ guns. Those organ guns. Whoops, my bad. I apologize. I hit the wrong button. Oh wow, it's over? They flee? Our army did suffer some pretty hefty casualties though, I will give them that. But, ooh! Still shooting him! Let's even kill those trolls outright. Here it comes. Here it comes. I mean, there's just so much fun with all of the freaking weapons we have. Flamethrowers and cannonade and organ gun. There's the smaller organ gun pellets and a cannonball slamming into the ground. Will we finish him? He's almost at the edge of range. Oof! That was close! That was close! Need a hit! Come on, gunners! Oh, he's out of range. Damn, he's gonna get away. Oh, maybe not. He's so close! Just hit him! Please! Don't disappoint- Oh, there he goes! He went down! He's got a hit point left! Oh no, he's dead! Oh, they got him! Oh, they got him. Great job in your first big battle, Alabaster, with Gotrek and Felix coming out with the most kills! Execute them captives.
Unto glory to the ancestors.
Considering you're in allied territory, you will reinforce.
Bring. What? Moving for the wisdom of the land.
Huh.
Aye. Grudges will be settled. We march. Let us begin. Move.
and that gives him nowhere to run. The Ever Watcher is hemmed in from all sides. Mio, renamed from Grudge Breaker to the Ever Slayer. And the armies of Lockhart are prepared. As is Jesse's forces, who are going to begin marching north to reclaim lands lost. Do we technically have Karak Ungor under our control? Karak Ungor. Through vassals or military allies. As Kislev. And a defensive alliance, no.
You will drink with us.
Elevate then to a military alliance. That should eliminate Karak Ungor. Good. The only places we have left belong to the Bretonians and our enemies. Let's see if we can shorten this campaign a little bit. Rather than going and fighting the Bretonians.
Welcome to Fair Bretonia, Commoner.
That will settle up that. And that means that all we have to do is march north to finish our campaign. Currently, the Warriors of Chaos possess how many? I have no idea how many hordes they possess. But according to this, that's the only horde we can see. So if the Everwatcher's horde is slain, that will leave him with nowhere to run. He can either retreat to Brass Keep or face our armies. There's nothing else he can do. Mio, it will reinforce for another turn, then can begin moving out. Tripod's moving. Stonefist is held in reserve. Zork is on his way to join the other armies. Alabaster is in need of reinforcing. He's going to take a couple turns after that big, brutal battle. And Durgis has been unleashed. Durgis, I'm actually going to order to move towards the lands of the Northmen in hopes of encountering them.
Summon me if you dare. Ready.
Rather than recruit slayers, I'm actually just going to order you to recruit. Actually, Zethbar's going to take 5 turns. It takes so long to just get this stuff. I'm actually going to order you to recruit another squad of each. You're going to go with a very basic army shadow so you can get into the fighting sooner. And here we have it. I have long marched north with all of my troops and all of the forces at my disposal. We have been ruthless!
Greetings, Sigma's chosen.
What do you want? Military alliance? I see no sense in it. There's nothing that I can really gain from being in an alliance with you, with an actual alliance with you, Sigmar. And he comes to face us! He comes to face us. Aaron Herbeard, you are tasked, along with Soa the Slimmer, with the slaying of the Ever Watcher. I hope you're up to the task, because it's going to be a brutal fight. And it's happening right now, actually. Not next time, we're not at the 30-minute mark yet. It's happening right now. The final showdown. We hope. Otherwise, I'm going to have 2 very dead generals. This is actually kind of terrible terrain for us. Actually, there's no kind of to it. It is pretty much terrible terrain. This is great up here, but it puts us way too close to his armies. We are going to set up here in the open. Ready to face them. We are not going to hide or sit anywhere else but directly here where they can see us and know we are here and waiting for them. Put the Iron Drakes back here where they can keep shooting. They basically can see us, they know where we are, and they know what we can do to them. And as soon as they crest that hill, we open fire. But while we're sitting here, these have brimstone guns, right? With armor-piercing projectiles? Fuck yes. Go! Go right after the hell cannons. The Dwarvish Air Force will be unleashed, and our ally is arriving very soon through here. Which gives me some faith and confidence. The gyrocopter bombs are what we really want to get off. Turn to avoid the hell. Oh shit, the hell cannons can seek. That's bad. Go straight in. Ugh. That is some dense AA fire there. But we're flying in anyway. Come on, I need you guys to get your bombs off. One of you got him off. And you are distracting the hell cannons admirably. Keeping them out of the fight for as long as we can, actually. Nothing can stop us. Now you're sitting inside their minimum. Oh, shit. You got another set of bombs? Good. Come on, you need to get through. Disappointing. But you have basically kept the hell cannon. You've kept four units out of the fight. Which is really what I wanted. Where's our ally? Get up here, wherever you are. We're gonna lose these. Actually, just retreat. Withdraw. Save these gyrocopters for later. You have done your job, which is to keep their artillery out of the battle. You haven't really inflicted any real damage on them, but you have effectively prevented them from joining the fight. And that's what I wanted. And now we are shelling back over here, it seems. Where's our ally? Where are you? Come out! There they are, finally. Reinforcements finally getting here. Are you really only going to let 20 on at a time instead of bringing on the full army? That sucks. We can kill those missile cavalry. Oh, the flamethrowers! Oh god, charred bodies everywhere! That's what we want to see. That's what we want to see. Ah! Alright, that gets rid of that unit. How do you like fire, sir? Alright, the fighting is on. Oh shit, I'm in control of these? Get over here. Ah. Continue to pour in all the firepower we have.
We fire on your command.
Shoot. Shoot into their ranks. Double time. Pour on the flames, pour on the arrows, let it rain. See if they can withstand cannon and fire. Actually, charge in. Stop. Shoot them. Shoot them. That's right, you better run! Shattered to pieces. I need you in here now. Move your ass, Joa. Move it. You can't miss. Gun it down. Cannon. Fire. Break those knights. Burn him alive! Burn the demon out of it! Slay and slaughter! Does he have armor or are they just punching right through? He has no armor! The flames are... Oh my god, we're literally... going to burn the Everwatcher to death! That's how it's done, Fire Drakes! Finish burning that carcass till it's nothing! Burn it alive! It's slain. Rescue them. Ooh! Oh, them trolls! Them trolls don't like it when you let them on fire! Burnt crispy troll! It's what's for dinner, ladies and gentlemen! Alley up! Cannons! On the hell cannon. Organ guns! On those hell cannon. Oh my god, we rescued this unit of quarrelers. Everything is shattered and running. But the hell cannons.
Withdraw, sirs. Withdraw. Iron Drakes for the fucking win! Oh my god, that was beautiful! You need to be running, Longbeards. You are getting shelled to shit. I don't mind if Joa gets shelled while we move up our cannon to fire back at them. Yeah, what's up now? How you like them apples? Counter battery fire. It doesn't feel good, does it? Oh no, the organ guns are in range. It's gonna be a battery fire between everyone. Oh, that's a dead cannon. You think that your puny chaos cannons can stand up to dwarven engineering? You are so very silly. You cannot stand up to dwarven engineering. You silly hellgunners. Ooh! Dead hellgun! Great shooting, lads. Kill the other one. Ah! I've had enough of your shit. I brought a hammer, says Joanna the Slimmer. And here comes Aaron Herbeard, the Ever Watcher. What do I need to call him? The Watcher Slay? The Ever Watchful? Oh no, wait. The Ever Blinding. There we go. The Ever Blinder. Engage that final hell cannon and annihilate what's left of his army. Oh! I didn't see that coming.
I am the ranking lord. Get your beards out the way, Darwin. We must fight. By Grimnir, I order thee.
I'm gonna hit that cannon. Oh! Point blank explosion! Get the fuck off my mountain! Literally. And Joanna standing down here, surrounded by a pile of bodies. One of the last vestiges of the Everwatchers' forces, looking like, I believe, Chaos Dwarves. Manning Hell Cannons. Ooh! Oh, whoa! Cookie was already dead! What was the point of that? You, shot a body in midair and just fragmented it into little bits! He was already dead! Ever Watcher, meet the Ever Blinding! It's over! Really? Really? He still rallies an army? He still rallies that army. Okay. They know the jig's up now. They suffered multiple defeats.
They know the jig is up. Hue burn relics. Ooh, weapon strength. That was Aaron's first battle. That was his first battle. I threw you into your first battle against the greatest foe we could have found. And you came out not dead. I honestly can't say much else.
It is time to war.
Eddie, finish the job.
On to glory for the ancestors. Boom! Ready.
Alright, well, Tango finished the job. You know, this is probably the last battle against Chaos. We're gonna feature it. Because it's gonna be the last battle against Chaos, and it's gonna be the end of the Chaos armies. Right here, right now. Are those allied reinforcements? The Empire? Everyone closing down to end this once and for all. They have the superior positioning. But they won't be able to do much of anything. I guess our dwarven guns, they'll have to pick if they're going to face us or the Empire. And it looks like they're coming towards us. This is the remnants of the Everwatchers. Holy shit! Where the fuck were you guys when we were fighting the Everwatcher, huh? You come in, you show up for the easy work, and don't show up for the hard work! Show up for the easy work. I see how it is, Empire. I'm glad I didn't sign that military alliance with you and we're only defensive allies. Show up for the easy goddamn victory. Don't show up for the hard, heavy lifting. I see how it is. Let them have it, Thunderers. Every bit of it. Ooh! Look at them Chaos Knights just fall! Uh-oh. They disappeared. That's not good. You think you're gonna march through this? Look at the hail of arrows coming at you with cannonade in tow. You're not marching through that. Yeah, there's none of your shit today, Chaos Knights. You don't even make it to the battle. Broken and shattered already. And sure, he doesn't have anywhere to escape to. And that's it. That's the end of the Chaos. Everyone, gun him down. Rulek da Demortum is the final champion of Chaos. This day. Look at all the shot. All those little white streaks are bullets and shots coming flying in at him with the intent to kill him. Just the sheer volume of fire. And we're still shooting at him. And the Slayers are going to catch him, obviously. They're catching up to him now. He ain't got much left, I don't think. Oh, he's dead. Oh, he... Oh, my God! Oh, God! He's dead! There's, like, no upper half of his body left! He's just a blood smear and guts on the ground! That's how you do it! Look at all these cannon impacts! Yeah! Yeah, we buried Chaos in cannonballs! Don't come back! That's what we gotta say. Don't come back! Is that it? That's it! That's it! Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, that is the end of the dwarf campaign, and you can see every little bit of movement right now. I'm sorry to the couple guys who got recruited in and we didn't quite get you into battle. And congratulations to Aaron Herbeard, holder of the title Everblinder. As well as congratulations to Mio, holder of the title Everslayer. Now, I could haul down and do the long campaign, but as you guys saw the computer moving, the Varg and the Skull are retreating back into the north already. It's just a matter of marching in and taking those cities. Which would be a lot of auto-resolve and a lot of just walk-through campaign, and I don't think that would be particularly interesting as we watch the campaign unfold before us. We're on turn 30 now, and as you can see, it's brutal fighting, particularly with the orcs. We've fought the orcs for so long. But we had a plan, and we stuck to the plan, and that was to annihilate all of the orcish tribes before we marched north upon the vampires. And here on turn 40, you can see we lost one city and had to take it back. By God. 136 turns later, the dwarves march out of Karak-Zak-Karak, and it took 130 turns, but we did it. We beat back the orcs. We beat back the vampire counts. We beat back Chaos and everyone who stood in our path. So now, we're going to see it play all the way through. Play out little turn by little turn. So you can see the Border Princes moving in to help us with the southern savage orc tribes. Before they became our vassal. Yeah, a lot of the humans, a lot of the minor human factions are now also dwarven vassals. That's how this played out. The Border Princes, Talaya, Kislev, and Middenland are human are dwarven vassals now. Human lands who are ruled by the dwarves. Now here on turn 67, I think this is about episode 12, 13... when we decided to finally start closing the gap and smashing down the greenskin tribes. As we're having this back and forth battle with the greenskins over little bits of territory and big battle waging that went all the way up to episode like 16. Just back and forth, back and forth. There's no real ground being gained except for in the very, very southern end of the Badlands where there's no armies to protect it. And then we started pushing into the vampire counts while we were at it. I said, screw it. Let's march north on the vampire counts while we're hard-pressed with the Greenskins fighting a war on two fronts at once to save Zuffbar, because Zuffbar had confederated with us. It's that blue right here. This blue right here is Zuffbar, and they had confederated with us at the time. Oh, shoot. So this up here was Zuffbar, who confederated with us at the time, and then once we got here, we confederated with these dwarves immediately in order to secure it out. And then from there, it's just a slow burn northward towards Chaos as we do these big fights with Chaos. The end of Chaos. Grudge reported. Warriors of Chaos destroyed. We recovered a banner and some additional troops.
My axe thirsts for war. Ready.
Ender of the end. Ender of end time. Hetty, my friend. Hetty Hellcannon Basher. And Aaron Herbeard, the Everblinder, Slayer of the Everwatcher. But I must give some credit to Joma here. And Joma will get his... Actually, Joma didn't really do much of anything. I can't give him a lot of credit. And of course, the Slayer of the Ever-Chosen, Neo, the Ever-Slayer. And his army, who have actually... None of these units were recruited once we'd researched technology to increase experience. This entire army was just built up off that experience, which is one problem I do have, is how long it takes to get XP for units. It takes a long time. Also, as you guys can see, the research tree here, we only got this far here, and this, we only got one of these. You really can't complete this research tree for the dwarves at all. There's too much. There's just, and this is with extensions on, so Chaos doesn't come until later in the game, turn 75, and it's still not near enough time to get any of this stuff really researched. I'm sad to say. If we had just strictly focused here, also, we would have lost, because we would have had too much corruption to deal with. You have to get Valea's protection. So you can either focus strictly on ranged units or strictly on melee and neglect the other one. Or you can completely neglect your income if you can somehow manage to make the money to fight, particularly early to mid-game. But once you get to late game, if you focus anything into income, you're making shitloads of money and you're fine. Like I said, the only thing missing for a long victory is to march up here and take this. Let me know in the comments if you guys want me to march up and finish that off. It will take maybe one or two episodes to really get in here and just bash through this and secure the last Dwarven Hold. But otherwise, that's it. That's... Actually, the worst part about all this, now that I think about it, while we go to the end credits, is I never got a chance to recruit Hammerers or Ironbreakers. If I completely neglected the Engineer's Workshop, I could have done it. But then I wouldn't have a lot of the Iron Drakes who were the primary thing killing the fucking Everwatcher with all of the flamethrowery goodness they were spraying down upon him. Wouldn't have had them. I would have had Ironbreakers and Hammerers, but I never really got a chance to get that, because getting a level 5 hold as the dwarves is seemingly impossible. I've still got 15 turns till I can get Karaz Akarak up to the max out level in order to get the Hall of Oats. That's brutal. That's super brutal.
Ready.
But yeah, that's my thoughts, my comments, and everything on the game. If you guys had a good time, make sure you hit the like button, seriously. Talk in the comments below. Tell me what you thought of the Dwarvy campaign. We're about to start the Empire campaign, by the way. So people who did not get involved in fighting, you're immediately going to get transferred over as new captains. So Durgis and Shadow, you're going to be my first captains in the Empire campaign. And people who would like to volunteer can volunteer in the comments below. If you'd like to support the channel, you can do this with a Patreon! Or you can click on the ad at the end of the video and go check out this episode's sponsor. Every one of those clicks also causes the sponsor to pay me a little money. Who knows? Maybe you'll find something you are going to enjoy and genuinely buy. I really don't know a lot of the time what the sponsor is going to be. It's entirely random based upon preferences for you. If you'd like to see the previous episode, it's right there. If you would like to rewind to part one and watch the entirety of all of the Dwarven campaigns, it's also right there for you. This has been Fiora, from my house to yours. I will see all of you guys next time. Alright, who stuck around? If you stuck around, gonna get a whoop whoop! We killed it! We finally fucking did it! The dwarves have done it! We've only been at this campaign for, fucking ever. July 2nd. We've been at this campaign. It's August 26th. That was brutal! God. That was super brutal. Anyway. So what's up, guys? How you doing? This is Fiora just giving you some real talk. Wink, if you stayed this long, by the way. And I'm curious, do you guys like the fox ears? Like, the ones I have now, or do you want me to see about getting some better ones? Up to you. I mean, it'll get added to the list of second monitor, dresser, other stuff I need. But it'll be high up on the list to get some new fox ears. But up to you guys. Let me know. In the meantime, I'll see all of you guys later! Where's my sandbags? I need to, like, duck and cover...